In this video, I'm going to show you a proper pistol grip. So I've got an unloaded firearm here. I'm going to go ahead and close the slide. Now, the first thing I'm going to demonstrate for right-handers, if you're left-handed, you'll want to reverse all of these steps. But so for a right-handed shooter, I'm going to pick up the gun with my right hand, finger off the trigger, and you see my other three fingers are on the frame of the gun, and I've got my thumb up here. Now you've got this open space here, and basically you want to take this part of your support hand, my left hand in this case, and you want to fit that right in there, and you basically want to feel contact with your left hand on the frame of the gun. Right, so along this axis is where the bullet and the cartridge is sitting, and when you pull the trigger, it goes bang. You have all this energy moving toward the rear of the gun, which is causing recoil. Now, if we were to have a vise where we could squeeze both sides of the gun from the left and the right, and then also another vise squeezing from the rear and the front, that would be able to secure this pistol to reduce that recoil. So if you think of your hands like a vise, there's two things that are going on here. The first one is called isometric tension. What isometric tension is when I have a grip on the gun, I'm actually pushing forward with my shooting hand while I'm pulling back with my support hand. So forward with my shooting hand and pulling back with my support hand. So you can think of that as the forward and rearward pressure of that vise. Now at the same time, on the left and right side, I'm squeezing with my hands. Now there's a rule that we talk about in marksmanship, it's the 70-30 rule. 70% of your squeezing power should come from your support hand, and since I'm right-handed, my support hand is my left hand, and then 30% of my squeezing power is in my shooting hand or my right hand. Now the reason for the 70-30 split here is because your support hand is going to help control recoil. So right, I have my hand forward of the gun, and I'm going to be able to get a nice strong grip on my left hand. With my right hand, the reason why you want 30%, which is less than your left hand, you want 30% gripping power in your right hand because ultimately you want your hand to be relaxed enough so that you can focus on your trigger control and a nice smooth trigger squeeze. If we had 70% of our squeeze coming from our right hand, your hand muscles are going to be tight and it's going to be harder for you to have a nice smooth squeeze on the trigger. All right, so to review, right hand, finger off the trigger, grip the gun, and then that left hand comes right in here into that pocket. Your thumbs can be forward. Some people like them out. I like to keep mine forward. I'm going to grip 70% with my left hand, 30% with my right hand. I'm pushing forward with my right hand and I'm pulling back with my left hand. And so now that you know what the proper grip along with isometric tension and that 70-30 grip split, you'll be able to shoot straight and have a good time at the range. And as always, remember that firearm safety begins with you.